Bali. Shruti Smriti. Days ago, we started looking into the Vaitathya Prakarana. The Upanishad is over. Okay. Now in this, the theme is the following. Upanishad says very clearly, Neha nanasti kinchana ekameva advitiyam. Therefore, all this shows that there is no duality, no multiplicity, no nanatva. Okay. So, what does it mean by telling that there is no nanatva? There are two ways in which we can understand that the nanatva we are seeing in front of us, those objects themselves are not there. This is one way of looking at it. Another way is, if you look at it from the point of view of the cause, okay, then Brahman exists. Therefore, it is not that it is not there. It is there. That Brahman is myself. Therefore, nothing is different from me. This is another way. You will avoid duplicity, multiplicity in two ways. The forms there are not there at all. One. Another way, all those things, they are myself, they are not different from me. This is another. Okay. Now, here, it has already been told that Turīya is there. We are Turīya. Therefore, when I stand in Turīya and say, there is nothing to see. Remember this clearly. If I enter into the clay, there are no parts and jugs. Not at all. Okay. There is only clay. Therefore, if I enter into Turīya Atman, there is only Atman. There is nothing else. No shapes, no form, nothing else. Now, therefore, whenever it says there is nothing, nothing, there is really nothing. But one who is not able to stand there and see, he always believes his eyes, he sees the multiplicity. Therefore, how should I understand? You say, then he says, what was, it is not at all there, but I am seeing means it is mithya. It is not there, but I am seeing, therefore it is mithya. How can it be mithya? I am actually seeing it. I am holding it, doing vyavahara. How can it be mithya? If you say, no, no. The very fact that you are telling that you are doing vyavahara, seeing and all that, it shows that you are not in Atman. If you were there in Atman, you would not have seen it at all. Okay. Then how should I understand this? You would understand that whatever you see is not different from you. Have you understood? Therefore, here, throughout Gaudapada, he is telling in this prakrata, in this section, nothing, it is vaitathya, vitatha, vitatha, not there, nothing. It is a dream. It is simply you are seeing which is not there, it is a sarpa. It is not all there. Only this he is telling. Okay. Oh, but in other place also he says that it is not different. Bhāṣyakāra again and again repeats. It's not there means it is not different from you. It is not different from you. He goes on stressing it. Okay. Therefore, there should be no misunderstanding in you. Namely, whenever it says it is vitatha, understand that by itself it is not there, but it is not different from you. Yesterday I have used the word. See, if you say without Atman it is there, it doesn't exist at all. Suppose you say, I am seeing, it is abhava, atyanta abhava. You say, no, I am seeing it, if you say, then it is mithya. Then you say, what do you mean by mithya? See, closely examine. Then you say, it is not different from Atma. The snake is not different from the rope. Therefore, three descriptions came in the process. First, you told it doesn't exist. Then you told it is mithya. It appears to be existing, it is not existing. Then you told it is pratibhasika satya. It is not different from that. That is, as your knowledge goes on increasing, you change the description. Have you understood? According to my understanding, it is telling. The first time I told it is different from Atman, there is nothing. Therefore, it is abhava, Shastra says. It doesn't exist at all. Next it says, when he argues, no, Atman also I know, etc., etc., if he says, no, then it is mithya. You are seeing something which is not there. How can I say something which is not there? How is it possible? Examine clearly what you are seeing. You are actually seeing Atman, but you are mistaking it for Jagat. Have you understood now? This the last one is the correct statement. See, everywhere this happens. When you say there is no serpent or anything, foolish fellow, you say. And afterwards you say, "Are what is it you are saying? I am saying the serpent is in your head, not here," he says. "What do you mean here? Then what else is there?" "You see, it is the rope. Have you seen three levels? Therefore, atyanta bhava becomes mithya. That itself becomes pratibhas satya. As your understand grows." Okay? So, pratibhas satya means it appears like something else. That is all. So, remember very well that there is no karyakarana bhava here. There is only ananyatva, non-difference, not through karyakarana bhava. Okay? So now tell it. Vaitathyam sarvabhavanam svapna ahur manishinaha antasthanattu bhavanam samvṛtatvena hetuna vaitathyam sarabhāvāna. Okay, for that Śankarācārya writes, see here, vitathasya bhavaha vaitathyam asatyatvam ityarthaha. See, look at the enormous clarity that Bhashyakara implies. All of you know asatya, when is that word used? Changing. Is it not so? Change, whenever you say changing, there is stuff inside it. It is not mithya. It is vyavaharik satya or pratibhas satya. Pratibhas satya also changes, you know. Actually, vitatham is, he is meant that it is just illusory. But he is telling asatya. Okay. Some people say, no, asatya, mithya, everything is the same. Okay. Don't take like that. You just follow closely what Shankara says. Then you will understand. Okay. Because he wants to stress finally, that it is not different from Atman. Have you understood this? He wants to stress that point. Therefore, he deliberately uses the word asatyam. As in pratibhasatya. Are all of you following me?
If he had used mithya, then it would have... If he had used the word mithya instead of asatya, then if it is mithya, how can it be not different from that?
Yes. Okay. Therefore, it is deliberately used, this word. Never try to interpret Shankara's words. He is careful enough to use what word he should use. He knows it. Never dare to go on interpreting him. Okay. Then, this asatyatvam, it gets extra meaning that it is mithya. As you go later. Now you want to tell asatyatvam only. So retain that word. Okay. Now, kasya, bolo. Sarvesham bahyadhyatmikanam bhavanam padarthanam svapne upalabhyamananam. Oh, there all the padarthas, bhavanam, sarva bhavanam, all the padarthas, all the thing you see, bahya adhyatmikanam, you see yourself and also something outside. Okay. Where? Svapne upalabhyamananam. In svapna, whatever you are seeing, everything is vitatha. Okay? Everything is vitatha. Ah, kathayanti manishinaha paramanukushalaha. They say that all this is vitatha. Really, those who know the truth. Okay. Vaitathye hetumaha. Bolo. Antasthanat. How do you say vaitathya? How do you say it is illusory? Because antasthanat, that is, it is inside. Okay. All the world you are seeing, all inside. Okay. Therefore, oh, obviously it's not possible, you know. All those things, the svapna is experienced inside when I'm sleeping. Therefore, how can the world be there? Therefore, because it is inside, it is another mithya, he says. Antasharirasya madhye sthanam yesham. Those in the within the body itself, those we are seeing, they are antasthana vaitathya. Yeah. Tatrihi bhavaha upalabhyante parvata hastyadeha na bahishyarirat. All the mountains and elephants that you see there, they are only, it's not outside the body. They are all inside the body. Tasmat te vithata bhavitam arhanti. Therefore, they have to be illusory. Understood? They have to be illusory. No, astral, they have to be, they are illusory. There is no doubt about that.
Now, vithata is meaning mithya. Milya.
Mithya.
Achha, it is saying the meaning.
Yeah. See, because when he is giving the definition, vithata, you understand, it actually means ananyatva. He wants to show that. Therefore, he says asatya there. When he comes to the drishtanti here, it is actually vithata. You know it, that it is vithata. It is illusory. You know it. Bolo. Nanu apaparakadi antarupalabhyamanihi ghatadibhi anekantiko hetuhu. What is asking is, are you are telling inside the body, just because inside, why should it be illusory? Just because it is inside. So many things are inside. For instance, in your room, there are so many things. Because it is inside, it is all wrong, is it? Illusory. In other words, being inside is not a sufficient reason to make it illusory. Have you understood? It's not sufficient. Just because it is inside, you can't call it as illusory. Okay. Therefore, samrudo. Then he ityashanka. Aha. Samrutatvena hetuna. Bolo. Samrutatvena hetuna. Samrutatvena hetuna. Actually, it's a very cramped place. Very cramped. Inside means not just because it is inside. It is too small. Okay. Antasamrute sthana dityartha. Nahi antasamrute dehantar nadishu. Parvathastyadinam sambhavasti. Nahi deve dehe parvathasti. Because where am I there at that time? I am in the nadis. Okay, when I am sitting there in the nadis and if I am seeing everything, certainly nadi is too small an area, constricted an area. You can't accommodate mountains and elephants. Therefore, it has to be mithya. Have you understood now?
These dreams are seen in the mind. Now it has come to nadi.
No, because where I am at that time? That is the question. That is the jnata. Where is he at that time? He is in the nadis. Now he is in the face and he is seeing through the eyes. His physical eyes, they come into contact with, they can receive outside information and give you. But there are no outside eyes. And he is there in the nadis. Therefore, whatever he has to see not with these eyes. There itself. Therefore, that is too constricted a place. It is not possible. Therefore, it has to be illusory. Okay? Then he says, another question. Another person asks. Svapna drishyanam bhavanam antasamrute sthanam ityetat asiddham. Yasmat prachyar suptaha udakshya svapnan pashyanniva drishyate ityetat ashankya aha. He told, this question is over. Somebody else asks. That he is inside the body, also I don't agree. That's not correct. What do you mean by inside the object? Why? He said, you have not proved that he is inside. Why? How do you say he is inside? He is asking the question. And he says, Bolo, adirghatvaccha kalasya gatva deshanna pashyati pratibuddhascha vai sarvaha tasmin deshena vidyate. You are telling he is simply outside, therefore he is going, he is wandering and all that. Don't use so much of logic. It is not correct. Because, no, the moment he sleeps, he will be in Kashi. Okay. Certainly there is no time for him to go from here to Kashi. Forget that also. No, when he is having the dream of being in Kashi, then he suddenly wakes up, he is here. Therefore, do you mean to say within that flash of a second he has come from Kashi to here? You can't say that. Don't use too much of logic. Yeah. That is, always remember, when we use logic, how we should use, direct to our experience, if it is opposite, you can ask. Otherwise, solely simply for the sake of discussion you make. That's all. Have you understood? Therefore, he says, don't use such a logic. You can read those things. The tatpari is only that. That much is sufficient. And that it is illusory, Shruti also tells. How? Bolo? Abhavascharathadinam Shruyate nyaya purvakam Vaitathyantena vai praptam svapna ahu prakashitam. Shruti says that it is illusory. What it says is, na tatrarthaha naratha yogaha panthano bhavanti atharathan ratha yogan patasrjate. It says, what does it mean? You are seeing horses, ratha, chariots. You are seeing horses, you are seeing roads. Okay. Na tatra rathaha. Ratha yoga means horse. Na ratha yoga ha. Na panthanaha. That is roads. Na panthano panthi. Pantha, panthano, panthana. Roads. Na panthano panthi. Atharathan ratha yogan patas rajate. But he is simply creating for himself chariots, horses and roads. Okay. He is creating for himself. Therefore, actually, what he is doing is, since that he is simply illuminating those all imaginations. Okay. Abhavascharthadinam sapnadrishyanam shruyate nyayapurvakam yuktitaha shrutavu. Na tatrathaha ityatra. Tena antasthana samvrtatvat adihetuna praptam vaitathyam tadanuvadinya shrutya svapne svayanjyotishta pratipadana paraya prakashitam mahuhu brahma vidaha. This we have already discussed. That is, there are no external lights there. But if there are transactions are happening, so how can transactions happen without light? But there is light also. What is that light? Whose it is? We have discussed this, remember. Okay. The light belongs to himself. This was decided. That is actually the prajna. Okay. Prajna is there in suṣupti, in svapna also he is there. So, from this prakasha, all this thing is illuminated. Just as you see, here, the cinema is recorded in daylight. Okay. Then, the film is developed. If you want to see the movie, once again the film has to be exposed to light. Only then you will see the movie. Isn't it so? Similarly here, the chitta is having all the memories. So he is moving only in the memories. At that time it is to be lighted, otherwise you can't see. Okay. Therefore, his light itself illuminates his own memories. And therefore you see the movie. And there, the mantra is intended to show there that he is Svayanjyoti. What is the purpose of the mantra there? That this jiva prajna is himself jyoti there. That is the purpose. It also incidentally confirms that all the ratha, ratha yoga and roads are all his imagination, surjate, he creates there. You are following? Okay. Now, read this next shloka. Antasthanattu bhedanam tasma jagrite smrutam yatha tatra tatha svapne samvrtatvena vidyate. No, Gaudapada is extending these arguments from svapna to jagrat. Okay, so he says, see roughly the meaning. See, similarly, antasthanat bhedam tasmat jagrate smritam. Similarly, on the same arguments, they say, all the multiplicity that you are seeing in jagrat, they are also vitatha. They are also illusory. Yatha tatra tatha svapne. Oh, as in dreams, here is also same thing. And it says, but one thing is different. Samvrtatvena vidyate. But one big difference is, because it is samrta, that is, it is in a crammed place, the dream, that is the difference. Here there is no cramming. There is that cramming. Are you following or not? See, cramming means, the dream world, where is it occurring? In a crammed place. In a very small place. In a very constricted place. Jagrat is not like that. The wide space of created by God is there. There is no constriction here, as in dreams. That difference continues to be there. But people who know say, in spite of it, what is just as it is mithya in dreams, in jagrat also everything is mithya. Okay. No, I have to get up from my seat. Okay. So, we just first read it. Jāgrat-drishyānām bhāvānām vaitathyam iti pratijñā drishyatvāt iti hetuhu svapna drishya bhāvavat iti drishtāntaha yathā tattara svapne drishyānām bhāvānām vaitathyam तथा जागृतेपि दृश्यत्वम् अभिशिष्टम् इति हेतूपनयः तस्मात् जागृते अपि वैतथ्यं स्मृतम् इति निगमनम् अन्तःस्थानात् संवृतत्वेन च स्वप्नदृश्यानां भावानां जाग्रदृश्येभ्यो भेदः दृश्यत्वम् असत्यत्वं च अविशिष्टं उभयत्र. नौ as I told you, I have to get up. Okay. See, first all of you remember. I think last time itself, these sentences have been read. Okay? But still once again, tell it. Karyamākāśādikam bahuprapañcam jagat kāraṇam param brahma tasmāt kāraṇāt paramārthato ananyatvam vyatirekeṇa abhāvah kāryasya. That is, all jagat, okay, the karana is parabrahma. Suppose if you look at from the point of view of karana, then everything is Brahman only. But if you say it is different from Brahman, then it doesn't exist at all. If you say part is different from clay, then such a part cannot exist. Okay. Then, see next sentence. Yadihi asatameva janmasyat janmas avyavaharyasya brahmanaha grahanadvara bhavat asatva prasangaha. What is telling you? Suppose they are all asat. That is not, don't exist at all. They don't exist. There is no way in which you can understand Atman at all. There is no way. See, an invisible thing, if it doesn't have indications, how can you see it? Thing is invisible. There must be some sort of indication. Therefore, the Jagat, Hiranyagarbha, all these things, they are all indications to see Atman. Now, if you say all this is Asat, there are no indications at all. How can you understand it? Therefore, indication is not different from the stuff, invisible stuff. Have you understood this? Yes, told. Okay, next. Brahma iva idam agre. Bola. Abrahma iva. Avidya drishti nam. Pratyabhasamanam. Abrahma pratyas sarvaha. Avidya matraha. Rajvamev sarpa pratyaha. It has been explained. See, the Jagat in front is indeed Brahman. But people with avidya, they see it as a Brahman, not Brahman. Okay. Therefore, it is just like this. Actually, there is only the rope. But you are seeing a serpent, different from that. Therefore, the serpent is not there. The serpent is only in your head. Have you understood? Similarly, if you think that this is Jagat independently, that is in your head. The Jagat different from Brahman is only in your head. It is not there. Okay. Then very emphatically it is told. Sadātmanā sarva vyavahāraṇām sarva vikāraṇām ca satyatvam. That is, all the vyavahāra and all the vikāra, if you look at it from the point of view of kāraṇā parabrahman, then they are all satya. Okay. Ekameva dvitiyam paramārthataḥ idam buddhi kālepi. When you are telling this one, this one, this rock, this river, even we are telling that, that is differently, this means, even then, ekameva dvitiyam paramārthataḥ. If you look at it from the point of view of cause, it is actually Brahman only. Again and again this has been told, remember this. Therefore, oh, nothing different is being told in Vaitathya Prakarana. That you must understand. Why I am telling all these things? Because Vaitathya does not mean it is not there. It is an absurdly wrong statement. These statements are not against what it is being told. This I want to present. Okay. Now, he also says that Swapna. Okay, now he is telling Swapna is Mithya. In Sutra Bhasha, it is being firmly told Swapna is Mithya. Then, what is the difference between the two? There is Kārtsnya in Jagat, in Jāgrat. There is no Kārtsnya in Swapna. Kārtsnya. Tāsānāya kārtsnya. What is kārtsnya? Kārtsnya is deśakālanimitta sampatti. That is, everything is causal. At this place, this happened. This took place. Therefore, this happened. Deśakālanimitta. Everything is connected. They are not disconnected. In Swapna, you will be going in a bullock cart, suddenly it becomes a plane. How it became, you don't know. It happens, is not so? Therefore, there is no deśakāla nimitta, sambandha there. Therefore, svapna, because there is no causal connections, it is mithya. Okay. Bolo? Nacha vyadadi sargasyapi atyantikam satyatvam asti pratipaditam hi tadananyatvam ityatra samastasya prapanchasya mayamatratvam praktu brahmātmatva darshanāt vyadādi prapañcha vyavasthita rūpo bhavati sandhyāśreṣṭu prapañcha pratidinam bādhyate. He says, of course we have been condemning that svapna is simply mithya, jāgrat is not so. But understand one thing, even this jagra, there is no atyantika satyatva. What does it mean? It is not an ultimate real quantity. It gets affected. How? Tadanyatvam marambana shabdadibhya. What does it mean? There is cause there. Okay. Whatever the multiplicity you are seeing, it is not different from that. Therefore, all causal connections are there, everything is going on, it is accepted. Okay. However, if you treat the forms, only the shapes independently, are you understanding? Independently, then certainly there is no satyatva there. This is only maya prapancha. Suppose you treat them independently, only maya. It's nothing like that. Perhaps you will all remember. These are some of the important things you can't afford to forget. If you forget, all the connection will be lost. What is told is, I told, how can that great Brahman, which is shapeless, which is actionless, it can stand in the form of Jagat? How can it be the cause? This question was asked. I have told three answers for this. All of you remember? Number one answer. Nobody in his theory also can give it. Therefore, I also won't give it. Why do you bother me? How can you press me? This is one answer. Another is, remember, we are more honest, not deceitful like you. You think you can explain. But Veda tells, I myself can't explain how Brahman became this. It says. And the third answer he gives is, okay, if you persist on that, I will say, you are kutastha ekameva dvityam in suṣupti, but you are yourself producing svapna. How did you produce? Actually, it's your own creation. Therefore, how you have done, Brahman also does in the same way. This is another answer. In other words, why I am telling this? Because how Brahman can take these forms is an unanswerable question. And this question is not only unanswerable, it is unaskable also. Why unaskable? Because the moment you have understood with kārikānubhava Brahman, then nothing is different from Brahman. Therefore, showing what you are asking, how this is created. How this is created. When you say, what is this? This is also Brahman. What do you mean by that question? Are all of you understanding me? How is this created? Say, what is this? This is Jagat. My dear sir, it is not Jagat, it is Brahman. No, answer me. No, ask the question. What is that to ask? Therefore, it is an unaskable question and an unanswerable question. Okay? Remember all these things. Now come to this this thing. See, you know Anumana Pramana? Okay. Anumana Pramana contains these following things. Okay. Where there is smoke, there is fire. Where there is fire, there is smoke. Where there is no fire, there is no smoke. Have you understood both sentences? Where there is fire, there is smoke. Where there is no fire, there is no smoke. This relationship is called vyapti. It's called vyapti. This relation between fire and smoke. This is called vyapya. This is called vyāpaka. Have you understood?
Swamiji, it is bigger letter may help and see.
Let us see. Are you able to see? No. Fire is vyapaka. Smoke is vyapya. Okay. Wherever there is fire, there is smoke. Where there is no fire, there is no smoke. This is called vyapti. Okay. Now, where there is smoke, there is fire when you say, as in the kitchen. That's a drishtanta. Okay? As in kitchen. As in kitchen. This is called drishtanta. That is example. Is it clear? Okay, now. You see, this is called anumana pramana. That is, when you are yourself inferring something, you do all this process. That is, to gain knowledge, you yourself investigate this. Therefore, this is svartha. It is meant for oneself. So this is called svartha, meant for oneself. When you want to narrate this to somebody, the same thing. You want to narrate it. At that time it is called parartha. Narration for the sake of somebody else. Narration for somebody else. That's called parārtha. Okay. Now you see. Now the question is the following. What he wants to prove, following. What he wants to prove is called pratijñā. Okay. What is pratijñā? He says, I am going to prove this. That's called pratijñā. For instance, here, I am showing that there is fire in the hill. There is a fire on the hill. That is pratijña. Okay. Now, write this. Fire on hill is pratijña. Okay. The reason is, since smoke is there, since smoke is seen, Okay. Now, since smoke is seen, is the hetu. What is hetu? Hetu, smoke is seen. Since smoke is seen, hetu. Drishtanta. What is drishtanta? Okay. As in the kitchen. As in kitchen. This is drishtanta. Okay. Then, the next thing is called upanaya. What is upanaya? You carry the information of the drishtanta to the hill. Okay. Hill is also having smoke. Hill is having smoke. A smoke is seen in hill. Huh? In hill. Smoke is seen in hill. That is, smoke is seen in the kitchen, drishtanta. I am carrying this drishtanta information to the hill. I think I understood. That is called upanaya. I carry it there. Okay. Smoke is seen in the hill. Smoke is hetu, hetu. This is hetu, this is drishtanta, this is upanaya. Hetu is the reason. Hetu is the reason. Okay. Drishtanta is as in kitchen. Apply this drishtanta to the arshtanta there. That is, smoke is seen on the hill. Therefore, because in the seal, the pratijna is proved. There is fire in the hill. Okay. Now, that itself is called nigamana. What is nigamana? I will tell you. Nigamana is repeating the pratijna. Repeating pratijna. Repeating the pratijna. That is generally, you understand that? How to say? See, I am going to prove that there is fire on the hill. Okay. How? See, I am seeing the hetu. And there? What if you see hetu? I am seeing in my kitchen smoke and there is fire, invariably. That is hetu. As in drishtanta. And carry this information. Similarly, it is also being seen there. I have carried this upanaya. Therefore, there must be fire there. That is, I am repeating the pratijna. This itself is called nigamana. Okay? There is no difference between pratijna and nigamana. Only you repeat it as if you have QED, you say, you know, and you have proved the theorem like that.
That is a hypothesis, this is your conclusion.
It's not hypothesis. You can say guess or something like that. Okay. Actually, pratijna is not a guess. It is actually called anumiti. Anumiti is conclusion. It's a conclusion. Pratijna.
Conclusion is nigamana.
No. There is no difference at all between nigamana and pratijna. Only repetition of it. This is the process when you are teaching somebody else. In all proving theorems also, we will prove that angle B equals angle C. You said, and at the end you say, therefore angle B is equal to angle C.
But the first one we call it hypothesis.
No. You don't say, certainly it's not hypothesis. That's what you want to show. That is the pratijna. It is not, hypothesis is assume. You don't assume it. It's already there. You know it. You are going to show only that.
Relation of fire and smoke is not always established.
No, see.
Smoke without fire.
Huh?
There is smoke without fire.
Actually, you are right. Okay. This discussion is also there. But now we will be going into some other area. It will be too much. Okay. For instance, people who smoke, you know. Okay. This also reference comes. The fire is out, okay, but they are holding their smoke only in their chest and then finally they blow it out. Okay, it could also happen. therefore, just don't go into those details now. Just take the example. I think it's already enough. Have you understood all these points? Now see, this is the case of smoke and fire that you have already seen. Now see, here in this case, what we are proving is the following. What is the pratijna? Jāgrat. When I say jāgrat, jagat in jāgrat. Jāgrat is jāgrat vaitathyam. Jagar jagat vaitathyam is the thing I want to prove. It's the pratijna. What is the hetu? Hetu is drishyatva. I am seeing the dreams. Therefore, drishyatva. Hetu is drishyatva. In jagrat. No, I'll tell you. No. That is drishtanta. Drishyatva in jagrat. No, in drishtanta, as in svapna. What is Upanaya? Carry there. Drishyatva is samana, there also it is there. Okay. Drishyatva is also seen here. Upanaya. That is Drishyatva samana, here also. That is carrying it to Jagrat. Drishyatva here too.
Carrying it to Swapna,
huh?
Because we are seeing the Swapna in Srishti in the Swapna, that we carry to the Jagrat.
As in, smoke is seen in the hill. Smoke is seen in the hill is also here. But now, from Drishtanta, I am carrying it to the Dharshtanta. From the kitchen to that hill. Drishyatva in Jagrat. Okay. So, then it's over. Nigamana is, therefore, jagrat vaitathyam. Okay? Just the same example, just apply it. But now, see here. What is written in Sutra Bhashya, you see. Here, the theorem is the jāgrat is also vitatha because it is similar to svapna. We know which is vitatha. The thing is not so. Remember this. That is, based on similarity, I am proving it is similar to this. Therefore, this is also mithya. Tell him. Now see some of the sentences. Anubhuya maya naam, bolo. Evam bruyat. I'm sorry. Upalabhyatehi. Pratipratiyam. Bahyortaha. Stambaha. Kudyam. Ghataha. Pataha. Iti. That is, upalabhyatehi pratipratiyam bahyortaha. All the outside objects in jagrat, you are seeing, it's a pillar, it's a wall, it's a pot, it's a cloth, etc. Nacha upalabdhamanasyaiva abhavo bhavitum arhati. Actually, what you are seeing, okay, what you are catching hold of, you can't say it is abhava. Yatha hi kaschit. Bhunjano bhujisadhyayam truptau svayam anubhumuya anubhuvamayanam evam bruyat naham bhunje navatrupyami iti bhruvan katham upadeya vachanam syat. He says, this sentence is the following, see, how strong it is. Oh, the external things when you are actually seeing and holding them, you can't say it is abhava. Can't say. It is something like this. A person has simply eaten well and by that he has been totally satisfied also. Then he says, Swayam Bhunvayana, he is experiencing it. In spite of it, he says, Naham Munja, I did not eat at all. Navat Rupyami, I am not at all satisfied. Okay. Suppose he tells that, Katham Upadevachanam Syat? Can you believe it? Can you take those words? Therefore, when you say all these things are there, when you are experiencing and you are feeling happy, okay, how can you deny their existence? This is in Sutra Bhashya. Remember this. Then see, Nacha Vyedad Sargasyapi Atyantikam Satyattvam Asti. That I have told. That is, there is no ultimate reality even in Jagrat. But still, we are not bothered about ultimate reality. At least now it is there. Ultimately, if you see it independently, it doesn't exist at all. We have told this here repeatedly. But at least it exists. Therefore, what the Vijnanavadins do is the following. Look here. This Jagrat Jagat doesn't exist at all. It is just like a dream. What is their argument? It is the Buddhist argument. They say, "Arey, I am seeing it. How do you say? It doesn't exist. Or you are seeing in dream also. But don't you know that the vastu is not there?" He says. Then Śankarācārya says, "Look here, you are caught here. When you say, when I am asking you, how do you say it is abhava? You say, as in dreams. Okay. As in dreams means, it looks as though it is there, but it is not there. So you agree that it looks it is there, but it is not there. And therefore you have already implied that here it exists. Therefore you are implying yourself believing, knowing that things are here. How can you deny them? Then finally he says, you read this important sentence. Anubhava virodha prasangat. Jāgarita pratyayānām svato niralammanatām vaktum aśaknuvatā svapna pratyaya sādharmyāt vaktum iṣyate nacha yo yasya svato dharmo na sambhavati so anyasya sādharmyāt tasya sambhavishyati. You know what he says? It's a very, very powerful statement. Remember, anubhava virodha prasangat. Why? What is anubhava virodha? Against experience. Jāgrat svapna jāgrat pratyānām svato nirmalatām vaktum aśaknuvatā. You are not able to show that all this is non-existing. You are not able to show in jāgrat. So now, you take the similarity with svapna, because things are also just like that. Therefore, this is also mithya, you are telling. Okay. Therefore, just by similarity, you will not be able to prove. Two similar triangles are not identical. Things may be similar, but you can't say that is equal to that. Have you understood this sentence? If you have understood this sentence, then you will be shocked at this theorem. Has it become clear to all of you? That is here, O drishyatva samanyat. Drishyatva is the only similarity. Asatyatvam is the similarity. Asatyatvam, drishyatvam is similarity. Just because this similarity is there, this is mithya, therefore that is also mithya. It is told here. Okay. Therefore, there is something, some fly in the ointment here. Something wrong. Have all of you followed me? Understood?
What is the analogy?
See, in place of vyapya, vyapaka.
Oh,
vyapya is drishyatva. Vyapaka is svapna. That is, see, drishyatva is smoke.
Vyapya is svapna.
Vyapya is svapna. Vyapya is svapna. As in svapna, as in the kitchen, as in svapna. Smoke is seen, drishyatva in jagrat, drishyatva in sapna also. Asatyatvam in both places. Okay. You have all taken down this? Can I erase this right side and write something else now? Okay? Because if I go below, you won't be able to see. Now, whatever jolt you have experienced, I want to make it more severe. Okay. Now, Let me take the pratijna like this. Fire on the hill was there. Or I would have kept that. Remove this. Okay, I will do it. You have got it anyway. Okay. Now on the same, based on the same theorem, I will put the opposite now. What is the opposite? You told here, jāgrat vaitathyam. There is jāgrat jagat is vitatha. Now, completely opposite to it, I will prove that svapna is satya. Svapna is not vitatha. Okay. I will take svapna. Svapna is avitatha. Like jagrat. I will prove this. What I will prove? That svapna is not vitatha. Like jagrat, it is also real. Why? What is the hetu? Drishyatva. Drishyatva, since drishyatva is there in both. Drishyatva, drishyatva in svapna. Okay. What is drishtanta? As in jagrat. What is upanaya? Drishya samanyatvam. Drishyatvam samanyam. Therefore, nigamanam. Svapna is real. The same theorem I have applied. I proved the opposite. Have you understood now?
As you told earlier, there is a difference between svapna and jagrat also. Difference, as you told, that is
samrtatva. Cramming is there. No. You. I told. No, I am going to disprove it. You take only the similarity. See, samvartatva is there. We have not taken into account. Samvartatva is there in svapna. It is not there in jagar. It is not taken into account here. Only the drishyatva and asatyatva are taken. Common. Have you understood? So, if taking only drishyatva into consideration and prove that jagrat is svapna, I will prove that svapna is jagrat. It's as real as that. I will take that also and do it.
When we say jagrat is avitat here, So what do we mean by avitat here?
Avitata means it is not mithya. It is real. It is not mithya.
Real in what sense?
Avitata in the sense, it is not mithya. It is real, it exists. It is a vyavaharik satya. It is vyavaharik satya. Okay? Svapna is also vyavaharik satya, I have proved. We know it is not vyavaharik satya. But you follow the theorem, I can prove the opposite also.
This is presuming that as a Vaishvadara, what I am enjoying in the jagrat is similarly enjoyed by the Tejasa in
Svapna. Okay, therefore it's as real as that. Have you understood now? Therefore, Is there something terribly wrong with this theorem? You can prove one theorem and also its opposite with the same logic. I think all of you have understood the problem.
Swamiji, then in jāgrat avastha, I am in dream world.
Huh?
In jāgrat avastha, all awareness, I am in dream world.
All these questions are arising because of the theorem, not because of me. Take this theorem. Oh, Gaudapāda has proved this theorem. Okay. What is the theorem? See, once again, he is comparing jāgrat and svapna. Okay. We know that svapna is mithya. And he wants to prove that jāgrat is also mithya. What is the reason that he gives? Hetu? Because drishyatva is samana in both. Okay. In other words, what he is telling? Keeping drishyatva and agreeing that svapna is mithya, he wants to show jāgrat is mithya. No, I do the opposite. Just as my experience here is in svapna, I know it is mithya. Okay. I don't know that jāgrat is mithya. But Gaudapāda has proved it. Okay. Suppose I start in the reverse way. I take my experience in jāgrat, it is not mithya. I use the same similarity and therefore say svapna is not mithya. And there is something wrong. It is going against my own experience also. This is also against my experience. When I say svapna is not mithya, that is against my experience. If you say that jāgrat is mithya, that is also against my experience. Therefore, there is something fishy in this theorem. Have you understood? Have all of you followed this?
No.
Avitatha. Vitatha means mithya. Avitatha means not mithya.
But this is okay, but earlier side, when we said that jagat is avitatha, so bhāṣyakāra is also that means asatya.
Afterwards it expands, I told you.
That is the swapan case.
Yeah.
In swapan case, it means without material, without stuff. That kind of mithya.
Yes.
But in jagat, it means asatya.
But Gaudapāda is proving it is mithya. That is my problem. I think all of you have understood. This question has not even been raised. This question has not been asked. Therefore, I want you to know how to study. You must be critically examining. Now we say, look here, the whole thing is very fishy, very confusing. But Gaudapāda cannot be wrong. And Shankara does not write a commentary on that. If it is so hopeless as this, Shankara will not write a commentary. Therefore, there is something wrong that we are doing. What is it? Are you understanding the analysis?
We are establishing fire and smoke.
Huh?
The relation of fire and smoke, we are taking too much the dependence on.
No. It is not a question of too much dependence, because fire and this also applies here also. Whenever fire is there, smoke is there. And there is no fire, there is no smoke.
Relation doesn't drishyatvam and svapna, that relation is not there.
Is
that? You sleep without dreams also.
What?
Relation is not distinguished.
Which is which relation? Drishyatva.
Drishyatva means svapna. You sleep without.
See, drishyatvam is there in svapna, drishyatvam is there in jāgrat also.
But there are sleep where we don't have dream. There are sleep where we don't have sleep.
That is suṣupti. We are comparing only svapna and jāgrat now. There is nothing wrong with the application of the theorem. The theorem is perfectly all right. But there is something wrong we are doing. What exactly is it?
Is it because we are not taking the whole, we are just taking the appearances only, therefore there is argument and logic is applied. But when we take the whole, there is no need of the logic.
Tell me once again.
I said, since we are taking this which is the appearance in the state upon the Brahman, like Brahman, we are negating it. We are not taking the whole. So that's why we are just, our arguments are only.
Have you got it? See here. Follow carefully. Here, it is our understanding of jagrat and our understanding of svapna. Okay. As far as our understanding is concerned, there is no difference between the two. As far as ajnanis are concerned, there is no difference. Have you understood? Because you see, where exactly is it? All of us know that in svapna, it is only smriti that is working and there is no stuff there. Everybody knows? See here, are you understanding? Everyone knows, he knows, he experiences. Though he is seeing a horse there, horse's body is not there. It's only horse's picture, memory is there. Everybody knows it. Okay. But in jagrat also, what we are seeing in jagrat is only that which is coming in svapna. And what we are seeing in svapna is the only thing that we are recognizing in jagrat. As far as ajnanis are concerned, there is really no difference between jagrat and svapna. Because both are recognizing only forms, not stuff. Is it clear now? In jagrat also, all ajnanis are experiencing only forms. Do they take Brahman into account? The cause into account? No, they are not taking. Have all of you followed this? Therefore, this theorem is a subjective theorem. It is not an objective theorem. What does it mean? Following my experience, the theorem is proposed. It is not pertaining to the object as such. My experience of dream and my experience of jagrat are identical. In other words, jagrat also, I don't see or experience the cause in the form. Only I see forms. The same thing is happening here also. Is this clear?
We also not saying when you say Christian path, there is duality. The one who is seeing and not is being seen.
What is wrong? The duality is not our concern.
No, but duality is with the.
No. There is no question of duality here. Taking duality into accepting duality. The duality that you see in jagrat is mithya, he is telling. Okay, but it is not mithya. We know it, our experience.
That duality is mithya.
Huh? Hare Rama, there is a lot of difference here. It is not the question of duality. We are not discussed with the duality here. Jāgrat Bhāvānām. That is the things that we are observing in Jāgrat. Are they mithya or not? That is the question.
If we do not see it with the
That means it's mithya-gyan. It's a mithya-gyan only. It is just identical to svapna that we are seeing without stuff.
The difference is the karan. Karan is the difference between jagran.
Not the karan. That's right. Not the knowledge of the karan. Knowledge of the karan. Okay? I think all of you have followed it. See, Śankarabhāṣya tells,
the karan of fire, karan of smoke was fire in earlier, and then there is smoke, the karan is Brahma, like that.
Actually, the kārikāna bhava that is being referred to is different. Here, fire is not upādāna kārana for smoke. Fire is not upādāna kārana for smoke. Therefore, that does not play any role. Only take the, even granting that there is difference, I know this much, that wherever there is fire, there is smoke, and where there is no fire, there is no smoke. Okay. Therefore, this relationship makes me conclude that whenever I see smoke somewhere, though I don't see fire there, I conclude that there is fire. Okay. This is called Anumana Pramana. Identically, science also follows the same, identically the same procedure everywhere. Only they don't give this example. That is all. Okay. But here, you are taking Sadrishya. Śankarācārya tells very, very clearly that there is, Aitareya Upanishad tells, Prasvapnaha, Avasathaha. That is, for this jiva, there are three positions and three dreams. Three positions and three dreams. Okay. What are the three positions? First in the netra, then in the hridaya, then in the manas, then in the hridaya. Netra, manas and hridaya. They are the three places. And tres svapnaha. Accordingly, there are three dreams, it says. And he says, how do you say it is a dream? Jagrat is not a dream. Yes? Jagrat is not a dream. But you are always understanding just as in a dream. Without the cause, you are understanding it. Therefore, that is also a svapna. That is, our mithya jnana itself is coming there. Our own mithya jnana comes. That is why Shastra says, when a person gets jnana, even the very nature of the dreams will be different. The nature of the dreams will be different. Okay? I'm sorry, I did not bring that important sentence. I will tell it tomorrow. Okay? Boliye?
Shankaracharyam, Keshavam Padarayanam, Sutra Padarayanam. bhāṣya-kṛtau vande bhagavantau puram pranam īśvaro guru-rātmeti murti-veda-vibhāgine yoma-vatyāpta-dehāya